You don't have to choose. They said what in the engine room? They're trying to decide between reliability-scented maintenance and FMEA, or failure modes and effects analysis? Mr. Froggy, you don't have to choose, and I'll take the bet that you don't have to. Here's my 100. Hi, everyone. I'm Nancy Regan, and I'm on Royal Caribbean's Allure of the Seas. And Mr. Froggy here, the towel animal, asked me, they're having some issues in the engine room, and he said, should we do reliability-scented maintenance or FMEA or failure modes and effects analysis to do an analysis to get better reliability on board? And I explained to him that you don't have to choose, that FMEA is part of reliability-scented maintenance. Reliability-scented maintenance consists of 7 steps. Steps 1 through 4 make up the FMEA. Step 1 is functions. Step 2 is functional failures. Step 3 is failure modes. And step 4 is failure effects. So you see, Mr. Froggy, when you do reliability-scented maintenance with the first 4 steps, you create a failure modes and effects analysis. So when you do RCM, the requirement for an FMEA is largely satisfied. Now, what? Oh, the other 3 steps? I'm so glad you asked. See, reliability-scented maintenance is super powerful. And if you just do FMEA, my mentor John Mowbray used to say that that's like just taking a bite out of the middle, because a lot of the gold is found in the last 3 steps of RCM. In step 5, we assess consequences of each failure mode. And then in step 6, we decide if there's any proactive maintenance we should do to manage each particular failure mode. And in step 7, we go even further than maintenance, because maybe we're dealing with a protective device, and maybe we have to do a failure finding task. Or, Mr. Froggy, maybe there are some better training procedures that need to be implemented. Or maybe a new operating procedure, or maybe a better tool would facilitate maintenance. So you see, when you do RCM, not only do you complete your failure modes and effects analysis, but then you get to make decisions on how to manage each failure mode. So there you have it. When you do reliability-centered maintenance, you automatically do an FMEA in the first 4 steps. And then you get to make decisions about maintenance and other actions to make sure you get the reliability you need. I'm Nancy Regan from the Allure of the Seas. Thank you for watching. And I'll take my 100, Mr. Froggy, and I might just go to the casino tonight. What do you know anyway? You're just a towel animal.